was discovered. Now let's do some more problems. Look at I just want to show of hands. Last class we discussed this G problem. How many of you do not understand the solution? Raise your hands. By the way, all the class videos I'm putting on YouTube. You know that?
No.
The 60 question is not required right now. And I have prepared, I have given a printout for a practice question paper. The same model in which I have set the actual paper. So entire section A, 25 questions are there. Similar type, same topic like that. And for section 2, you have 9 questions of 65 marks. Okay. So
how many marks?
Listen carefully now. 9 questions of 65 marks.
When we totaling
65 marks, section A is 25 marks, so totaling 90 marks. But then when we set the paper using past paper questions, we found that it seems very tough for you at this stage of your skill development. So we are planning to reduce the actual past paper questions and introduce some of the questions based on your workbook, worksheets, what you have practiced, so that it becomes easier. Yeah, based on what you have done in your workbooks, the worksheets I have given,
the paper.
The last time there were questions for you.
So it will become easier for you.
So you put more questions.
Past paper questions seem to be tougher from your point of view.
So are we getting a copy?
You said that is paper I have given a printout. I don't know whether it's ready. Can you go down and see
whether the practice? I'll check.
Okay, wait. At the end of the class, just wait 2 minutes.
Okay, next class are weekends or stars?
Yeah, exactly. Weekends or stars?
Oh, we don't have
any more
class today.
No, we do.
So, what's the maximum marks? 25. It's not like that. Actual exam can be of any mark. We will convert it to 80 marks. Internal 30 marks. But how you get 100? So I can test you in different ways.
So you said you use practice questions. Can I ask you a question outside the question paper? The question paper is being printed right now.
So I need to staple the sheets so that we have 15 sets which I can give you. So tomorrow you can collect it.
So can I ask you a question if we are done with today's lab?
No.
So you give us one practice problem.
Is there only 5 minutes are left?
Okay, now tell me this.
Let me ask a question.
Let us say from a height of 20 meters. And another 5 kg ball is thrown down.
At
10 meter per second. Okay, which ball? This is ball A. This is ball B. Which ball will hit the ground with more speed?
A.
You don't need to write the question.
Video के अंदर आया.
Which ball will hit the ground with more speed?
A, because you have to go up and then throw it down.
So B.
Those who say A, raise your hands. One, two, three, four, five. draw from the same height. From a height of 20 meters above the ground.
Yeah.
A is thrown up with 10 meters per second.
Yeah.
How do you use this?
Down with 10 meters per second.
With force.
10 meters per second?
I think B.
Down with 10 meters per second. So which will hit the ground with more speed?
I think
A.
So
I think
it's
equal.
A. I think it's
B.
B. I think B or equal.
So I think it's
equal. Oh, you want one more option? Equal.
Yeah.
I think
it will be B.
Because at the starting point of time, the force and the friction would be.
I'll explain. So
there
let
is no
me
friction here.
when that ball is thrown up, when it stops, it's at zero, and again it's coming down to the same force as B. That's
same
right.
Speed.
Speed. Sorry, speed.
Any object which is thrown up with a certain speed, it has a constant acceleration in the downward direction.
Yeah.
Initially, it will slow down to zero. And then it is going to have whatever acceleration slowed it down, same acceleration will speed it up
yeah.
by the same amount. So from 10 meter per second it went to 0. Over same time, same distance, again from 0 it will come back to 10.
Yeah. Sir, doubt.
So both are actually
equal.
Same situation.
Sir, SE question is.
They are starting with same speed from
equation
same height. So from 10 it will again travel 20 meters. It will accelerate
yeah,
for
yeah,
same amount
yeah.
of time.
Yeah,
but
my
there's
no
voltage
is
resistance.
No air resistance.
So,
but
so the end of paper,
supposing there was air resistance.
No, let's not talk about air resistance.
So if there was.
If there was, then still it would be equal.
Because it would just be
that the ball would travel, the ball A would travel more distance with terminal velocity than ball B. But
yeah.
the terminal velocity would be equal for both.
No, if there is air resistance, what will happen is, because it has 10 meter per second, and it is going in the upward direction.
It
will slow down very quickly. Okay? And
come down
all it will come
but
to
sir,
zero.
Zero.
It will not go to the full distance.
Also, sir, jitna bhi jayega to zero
hoga. Let the other person
speak.
So from 10 meter per second, if no air resistance has been there, let us say it will go till here. With air resistance, it will go only till here, let us say.
Yes.
And then now it is going to fall down only this much. So it has less time acceleration downwards, so the speed it reaches here will be less than the 10.
Okay, sir.
So, but even the force
in
which
B was
thrown down will be
decreasing. Even that speed,
yeah,
even that speed which it reaches will be even lesser due to air resistance.
Yeah.
Whereas this one started with 10 meter per second and then slows down due to air resistance.
Okay.
So, this will hit first,
got
then it. This.
So, question, sir.
With air resistance.
So, what would be the equation for this? Would be if you ask
so
such
do
a
it,
question.
Do it. So we want to find B final for A, B final for B.
If you want to find B,
let us
U
say
plus
we want to solve it.
U plus AT.
Let us say we want to solve it. So I'll do it quickly on the board.
U plus AT.
I'll demonstrate all the rules which I told in the last class. First step is book side.
Book side. We are book side.
For ball A. For ball B. And I am going to consider up is positive, down is negative. Please follow these rules. Right next to hook side on the left hand side, show me the sign convention you are going to use. So initial velocity is plus 10 for A. So plus 10 for A. For B it is?
Minus 10.
No, it's not B, it's U.
Minus 10.
Jaldi reverse to jaldi.
Acceleration is.
Are lenenge late.
Minus 10 meter per second squared. Minus 10 meter per second squared.
For A.
But A
now displacement is.
So how is it minus 10 for A?
Both going up. Acceleration due to gravity is downwards.
Okay, got it.
He dosed.
Which we call minus.
अच्छा सर आप मेरे को एक क्वेश्चन का आंसर दो।
Displacement is downward direction 20 meters. So displacement is minus 20 meters. Board obstruct the board please. Here also minus 20 meters.
Here and
on. See, displacement is final position minus.
Yeah, got it. Next.
So now you can solve for V using this.
U x.
So V square equals U square minus 2ax.
V square is U.
Sir, what is terminal velocity?
Not in this class.
We have not done anything known as terminal velocity.
Once in class, man.
The speed increases. Yeah.
Who is taking our paper?